In 1900, at the turn of the century, Downey was a small agricultural community, primarily comprised of citrus groves and dairy farms. There were, however, enough boys and girls of high school age that a group of citizens got together and organized what was then called Los Nietos Valley Union High School. On August 16, 1901, Los Nietos Valley Union High School became the 11th high school in the Los Angeles County school system. But naming the high school was pretty much putting the cart before the horse, because there was no building for this school. The high school found temporary quarters for its 45 students in the Downey Grammar School Auditorium at the corner of 2nd Street and Downey Avenue. The high school faculty consisted of one principal and one teacher. The first graduating class of 1904 had four students who received their diplomas. In 1905, the first building at 2nd and Church Streets, where the new A building now stands, was built. The original cornerstone of the first building with the initials LNVHS is preserved, and it lies in front of the Viking Bell Tower. The name of the school was changed to Downey Union High School in 1915. The following year, the school got its first bus, since the only previous transportation had been supplied through Miss Van Meer, who used her car to bring students to school. In 1922, a new structure with 14 classrooms was built to accommodate the growing student body. A two-story administration building facing Firestone Boulevard contained the administrative offices, the auditorium, and classrooms. High school graduation, as well as plays and concerts, took place in the auditorium. In 1926 through 1927, the original 1905 high school building was condemned as a fire hazard and torn down. A gymnasium and a manual arts shop building were erected on that site. The gymnasium housed both boys' and girls' locker rooms. All-night basketball games and school dances were held there. The manual arts building provided classroom for mechanical drawing, auto shops, and welding classes. In Downey of the 1920s era, as in many small communities even to this day, the high school was the center of social life and local interest. The auditorium was used for public functions such as town meetings for the discussion of local problems. Dances and rallies were held there, where the whole town turned out to support the local teams in athletic contests. It was the focal point of civic pride. It was one of the most handsomest buildings in town. In 1928, a junior high school was built on the high school campus. So, Downey Union High School became comprised of two schools on the same campus: Downey Senior High School, grades 10 through 12, and Downey Junior High School, grades 7 through 9. The original junior high school building remains today and is the present day R building. In 1936, a large swimming pool and locker rooms were completed. These facilities were a rarity for the schools at that time. The original Downey swimming pool, called by locals as Downey Plunge, was located where the outside stage and T building classrooms stand today. In 1941, the high school classroom building, located north of the other buildings, was erected. History, English, Spanish, algebra, drama classes, plus a course called Senior Problems, were held there. Back then, lockers were part of the campus, and every student had a locker for their textbooks and supplies. During the war times, the student population and campus life reflected a change as some of the young men, high school students, left Downey to serve in the military. In 1944, Volsong Yearbook reported that, "We are no longer the happy-go-lucky, carefree students, but we are students turning all our efforts to a wartime theme. When Uncle Sam invaded our school, meaning the boys were drafted, the girls began taking over. They voluntarily rolled bandages for the Red Cross. In 1944, the first girl student body president in the history of Downey Union High School was elected. The school newspaper was edited by a crew consisted of mostly girls during the second semester. Times were changing. And when times change, the schools mirror the changes. Clubs and school activities also reflected the interests and the community of the day. The gymnasium was demolished in 1957, and the original Walker Hall, A Hall, constructed in its place. It was named in honor of William H. Walker, a retired teacher and former superintendent of Downey Union High School. After World War II, in the 1950s, the city of Downey's agricultural lands were given away to residential subdivisions, and more families, baby boomers, moved into Downey. So, more schools were needed in the city. From 1952 through 1959, five junior high schools were built for students in grades 7 through 9, meaning Downey Union High School was then for students in grades 10 through 12 only, and was renamed Downey Senior High School. In 1957, a second senior high school, Earl Warren High School, opened its doors. And in 1961, all the school in Downey, elementary, middle, and high schools, were unified into one big school district. In the 1990s, major renovations were done to R, S, and J buildings. A new pool was built on Brookshire. In the early 2000s, new buildings B and C became part of the school. The football stadium was rebuilt with new turf, track, and grandstands. Just in time for the start of the 2014 and 15 school year. A brand new Walker Hall was dedicated with over 1.2 acres in square footage, housing the administrative offices as well as classrooms. A state-of-the-art career technical education building, known as the D Building, was open for classes that provide Downey students with one of the finest facilities in the country for college preparatory and career path courses. Another campus feature was the addition of the bell tower. Note the campus photo from 1947, the open space where the bell tower was to be built in the 1950s. The Viking bell tower was built to ring out victories. Sometimes the bell rang out weekly, but from 1962 to 1970, the bell tower was silent for Viking Football League games. Finally, after nearly a 9-year dry spell of no league wins, the tower chimed out a Viking victory in October 1970. Another addition, although brief, was the donation of the Viking statue by Key Club in the 1968 through 1969 school year. By the early 70s, the Viking disappeared. Alumni still wonder about the fate of this statue. In looking at the student enrollment over the years, Downey High had 66 students in 1907. In 1928, just before adding the junior high school to the campus, Downey Senior High had 196 high school students. In the fall of 2014, there were over 4,200 Downey High School Vikings on campus. To give a frame of reference, in 1940, the population of the city of Downey was 12,000. And in 2012, the population of the city of Downey was about 113,000. Another marker of time, the cost of a yearbook. Did you know in 1970, the cost of a Downey yearbook was $7? Today, the cost of a yearbook is about $100. Downey High has alumnus who have been Olympic gold medalists, accomplished professionals in science, technology, and the arts, and served as community leaders and humanitarians, people who have given back. The school's Hall of Fame is a place where some of those former students receive honor. There is a wall of fame in front of J Building, as well as a tribute in C Building hallways for these classmates. Downey's alumni also demonstrate loyalty to country and serving in the armed forces, and some have paid the ultimate sacrifice. A tribute to the fallen heroes of Downey High School is in the second floor hall of Building B. Now that you have looked at where Downey High School has been, let's return to the present and see Downey High School today.
In a recent staff meeting, the teachers were polled on how many of all of us have attended Downey Schools. And it turns out that over 55 teachers attended Downey Schools. And more specifically, 21 of the teachers are graduates of Downey High School. I count myself pretty lucky that I'm among that group, and I can tell you why they want to come back, because the teachers found such a rich experience here at Downey High, and giving back to this school district, and especially to the school, is going to make a big difference.
Hey, I'm Mr. Russell. I'm a 1985 graduate of Downey High School, and I just want to talk to you a little bit about what I think Downey High School has done for me as a graduate, now having worked here for 20 years. Downey High has provided me with an environment that has allowed me to hopefully reach my personal growth, to reach my best. I remember being in high school and thinking that Downey High School was a great place to be in, a terrific environment with great friends and good teachers and people that cared about me, and that gave me a good feeling and a good sense as I went into the community and went to college and decided that I wanted to become a school teacher. And now coming back and having taught for 20 years, I've tried to foster that environment in my classroom and with the students here at Downey, that it's good to care about each other, it's good to be a part of something, and I think Downey High School provides that, and I really like the environment here at Downey High School, not only with the people I work with, but of course the students that I'm in contact with every day. And I just wanted to share that with you guys, that Downey High School really is a terrific place that promotes that, and let's keep up the good work.
Something that I learned that was really, really valuable from Downey High School when I was a student is to lead by example. It's also something that I use as a teacher. If I want students to be respectful, I need to show them respect. If I want students to be responsible, I need to be responsible myself. It's really important that we show through our actions, not through our words, how we feel about people. So if you care about Downey High School, show Downey High School by your actions and not by your words.
We are very blessed to have such a wonderful school. I love coming to work here every day, love the students. We have a lot of learning opportunities here. Some advice that I would give to the students would be to stay positive, work hard, and then work harder. Learn from your mistakes, nothing happens overnight.
Respect for me is a big deal in my life. You know, it has a lot to do with how I grew up and the way I'm raised and how I am now. I live by the three R's. It's responsibility, respect, and responsibility for the others around you.
Respect to me is treating people how you want to be treated, but you also have to respect yourself first in order to figure out how to respect other people.
One thing I want to say is respect starts with yourself. As soon as you respect yourself, the possibilities are limitless in what this school can do.
Like, respect is how you treat others and yourself, not mainly about what your friends influence you, but how you can set an example for others. Just because your friends want you to do something doesn't mean it's the right thing to do. You have to have self-control and set another example for others.
To me, respect is treating people the way that you would like to be treated and the way you should treat people.
It's really easy to respect someone else, you know, just say hey and smile at other people, because it can make someone's day go by really great.
Respect is basically built on the basis of treating others the way you want to be treated, and you obviously do that by respecting yourself, and that's how you will earn the respect of others in the future. And as you build relationships with people around you, and you get them to respect you, with that also comes trust.
You should treat others the way you should want to be treated.
I believe respect is a big key to life in many ways. First, as a child, as a middle school student, that wasn't the best thing. Constantly got in trouble for it, sent up to the office for being disrespectful, and it caused a lot of trouble to me mentally and like around. Once you lose respect for someone, the word goes around, and then you're known for not being respectful. So as being respectful, it will gain trust with others.
My experience with respect was in my freshman year of girls basketball. I wasn't the most respectful player. There were things that my coaches told me to do that I didn't cooperate with. But as the years started to go by, I started to see that as I gave my coaches respect, I'd earn that back.
I was disrespectful. I didn't really care about school, but then something just clicked, like a light turned on, and I was like, school matters. Like, I can't be disrespectful to my elders. Those are the people that are gonna guide me through school. Like, they're the ones helping me step by step.
growing up and going to other countries, you know, you have to be very respectful to the way they live and the way they are, and you know, you have to do that, bring it back with you home.
Respect has taken me a long way, and I look back at it and I wish I could have respected people that I didn't respect, because now I need them. But from now on, the only thing I do is respect others and just keep respecting.
I feel like DHS is a really good school. We unite as one. We're always there to support each other. We have had a loss. Our football player, Dodie Souza, we all united and showed support to each other.
Respect with me has helped me in many ways throughout Downey High School. As in, me, when I would see administration, I would say hi to them. Once in a while, I would say good morning, afternoon. And by that way, I guess I got trust from administration, the securities, principals, vice principals, and that as a currently Viking, I work in the school farm, and I could say thanks to respect, I got that.
I've learned at Downey High School that if you respect yourself and respect others, that good things will come to you as they've come for me. So just keep respecting others, respect yourself, and respect the school.
We have 4,500 students. 4,500. I mean, that's one of the biggest in the nation. And with self-respect and respect for others, what we can do at this school is has no boundaries whatsoever.
I graduated in 2012. And when I was a Downey Viking, I learned a lot about a great deal of respect and working with others. As some of you guys probably know, I participated as a football player all 4 years, and working with my teammates here at Downey High, and always being a leader on the field as well as in the classroom, it really transferred over to when I went to college and how I am as a man today. And some things that I really learned when I was here at Downey High is just about respecting one another. And like I mentioned earlier, leading by example. You know, most people in high school, you kind of want to fit in with the crowd, and like some people are afraid to be individuals, but really being a leader and stepping up and leading by example actually gets you more friends than, you know, kind of being with the crowd. And that's something that I learned, being a leader on the football field as well as like out in the quad at lunch and snack. Also, like I mentioned, being a leader out on the football field, like to get our football team better, holding guys accountable in practice as well as in the game. You see a teammate down, instead of, you know, having an attitude of like, oh, I'm having a good game, encourage that guy to do better, because at the end of the day, the team is going to do better and get the W.
All right, so what can I tell you guys that you haven't already heard? I'd just like to give you my point of view on respect. Respect is gained, all right? If you want to respect someone, then you need to do what's right. And that's a tough thing to do, because a lot of times it's very easy to do what's wrong. But if you respect yourself, if you respect the school, if you respect the way that you were brought up by your parents, when you're up here at school, just make it happen. It's all about character. It's all about being true to who you truly are. A lot of times we just try to fit in and try to figure out who we are, who, you know, who can we be accepted by. Don't worry about that. Be yourself. That's the best thing that you can be, because nobody else can do you better than you are. Okay? Be yourself. It's all about respect. Remember that. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Find out what it means to me.
A landmark that is now showcased is the Valley Oak Tree and Circle Drive on campus. It is estimated to be about 100 years old as Downey High School. Interesting to note about this tree is that the root mass is actually about 3 times larger than the span of the tree's canopy, meaning what we see above ground is far less than the underground roots that give the tree its life. In the same way, the teachers, counselors, and administrators at Downey High target to build within students' deep roots in character through instruction. The goal is to instill students both roots to be grounded in character and wings for the students' future success. Downey High is not just about the buildings. The students are what make the school come alive. They are, you are, the spirit of the school. Downey High is proud of its heritage, boasting of its students of the past, and anticipating the accomplishments of the students of today who carry forward these traditions and make their own paths into the future.